Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video I'm going to talk a little bit about my experience as an exchange student in Trondheim in Norway. So most of you already know that in 2014 I decided to take a semester as an exchange student with the program Erasmus+. And I left my home country, Portugal, and I went to Norway and I studied in the university called NTNU and I studied architecture. This is actually one of the most requested videos from you guys, so I really hope you're happy and that this video can help a lot of you to decide if you want to study here or just if you are already coming here to make you a little bit less worried. Because I remember before I came to Norway in Erasmus, I was so nervous, especially the 2 weeks before I came here, I was freaking out because I was so afraid to come to a very far away country where I didn't know anyone else and I had to live alone for the first time. It was really exciting in a way, but it was also super scary. Here in this video I'm going to basically talk a little bit about my experience, but not about the protocol and all the things I had to do to be an Erasmus student. That I already have a video that explains more or less what I had to do. It's called My Norwegian Journey, so if you want details about how you can come here, what you have to do, then you should check out that video. I'm also going to show you some videos that I made at the time. They have really poor quality. They are like really stupid videos because I didn't have a YouTube channel or anything like that at the time, and what I used to make was like kind of vlogs to myself so I could remember, or I would vlog myself speaking to show my mom. I'm going to put subtitles so you guys can understand what I'm saying, so just activate the subtitles. I will also have a blog post about this with a lot of pictures from my experience as an exchange student. So if you want to see more, you can go to the link that I have in the description box and you will go to my blog and see the post I have about this. So I'm going to start from the beginning. I came to Norway, to Trondheim, in January. I was already late when I arrived because there's normally this first week where you meet everyone and have like this tour around the school. I regret a lot not being able to have that week because I really think it helps a lot and you meet a lot of people. I had to take two planes from Portugal to Oslo, and then in Oslo I changed flight. It was super cold, a lot of snow and ice everywhere. I remember my plane had a lot of trouble to land. It was a bit emotional and very nerve-wracking, especially because I hate flying, but it was okay. I also arrived in the middle of the night, so it was like 11 o'clock here in Norway. I had to figure out how to catch the bus. Then I arrived to my student village where I had my apartment, and since it was in the middle of the night, I had to go to a special place that had this safe box, and I had a code that I had to put on the safe box so I can open it and take my key, the key of my room. And then I had this really crappy map of the student village, and I had to find my building, and I was completely lost with all my luggage. And then I found someone that helped me and even helped me carry all my luggage up the stairs because my apartment was on the 6th floor and there was no elevator. I finally was at the door to my apartment and I really thought that I was going to open the door and there was going to be a lot of people there, like, because I shared the apartment with three more people, so we were four in an apartment. So I really thought that when I opened the door I would see like my flatmates and we would introduce each other and everything would be really cool and funny, but it wasn't at all like this. I opened the door and there was no one. I went to my room, the room was completely empty, just had a bed, a desk, a chair and the closet. It was super cold. It had this huge thing like to heat the bedroom on the wall, but I couldn't manage to make it work. I thought it was broken or something, so I actually slept all dressed up with my like outside clothes because I was so cold. I knew there wasn't going to be any sheets on the bed or any pillow or any blankets, so I brought some like thin sheets from Portugal and a pillow, but even those didn't help because the beds in Norway are longer than the ones in Portugal, so my sheets didn't actually fit the bed. It was a bit chaotic and with a lot of fails. I remember I felt so lonely and so stressed, and I even called some of my friends because it wasn't what I imagined it would be like. I actually met my flatmates the day after and they were really nice, so yeah. Okay, so now I'm going to show you this video I made. I think it was to show my mom where I lived, like how was the apartment.
Isto é minha vista, minha secretária. Pois, isto é o meu armário, minha cama com a minha mesinha cabeceira. Por aqui. E entramos. E é assim: a sala, o nosso sofá, a cozinha, que eu estou a fazer soltar. Isto é o meu lado da casa de banho, com a minha toalha, o nosso coisa para lavar as mãos, é o duche, a sanita.
As you can see, I had basically an apartment with four rooms, then we had this like common kitchen in the middle and a common toilet. Living alone for the first time also meant that I had to learn how to wash clothes. We had this like common place that we could use the machines to wash the clothes. And then we would take the clothes wet, like in really big IKEA bags. And we had this string in our ceiling that when we put it there, we were really, really smart about it. And we would hang our wet clothes in our ceilings. It was crazy, but it worked. And it also means that you have to cook by yourself, learn how to cook if you don't know. I would cook my dinner and I would cook lunch to take to school. The student village I was in was really, really nice. I loved Moholt. I would recommend it to anyone that goes study to Trondheim. Most of my friends were not really from my class or from school. It was people that I would get to know in this community where I lived. We had a lot of parties in each one's homes. I have a lot of videos of the parties, but I'm not going to put those here because most of the people that appear in this video are still my friends and they would kill me if I share this. Then when the classes start, I would walk from Moholt to the university. You can do it, it's not really far away. You can also take the bus, but the bus tickets were very expensive for me, so I would always walk. I also know people that had a bike, for example my boyfriend, we were both exchange students there and we met there, we met each other there, and he had a bicycle. The university campus is huge, it's gigantic. You have very new buildings and very, very old buildings, like Harry Potter style, what makes it really cool. They even have workshops, huge workshops, where everything you use is free, so you don't have to buy it. Since I was from architecture, I use these workshops a lot. They have everything you can ever imagine for students. The university is really, really close to the city center, so you can also walk from the university to the city center. And I made this vlog on how it was to walk from school to the city center.
Okay, ali, faculdade, certo? Edifício principal. E por aqui, vamos para o centro. Ponte para o centro, Rio de Trondheim, ali ao fundo, Igreja Nidaros, e o rio chama-se Nidag. Essa coisa vermelha é da Associação de Estudantes, eles dão festas, não sei o quê, chama-se Samfurné.
The town is very small, but it has a lot of things happening. It has a lot of like traditional Norwegian houses and full of history. Oslo is not that real Norwegian, and I felt that Trondheim was, so I miss it a lot. Okay, so now I have to start talking about the weather, because I am from Portugal, and before I went to Trondheim, I had seen snow, I think, once or twice in my life, and it wasn't that like amazing snow, it was just like snow. So when it actually snowed, it was like a dream come true. Every time it snowed in Norway, I would film it. Every time. When it snows in Trondheim, it really, really snows. It's difficult to walk, the stairs especially get frozen underneath the snow, so sometimes you put your feet on the step and it's not really a step, it's just like a giant icy slide. I would fail so many times that I like kind of taught myself to fall in a really cool way and then stand up and pretend nothing happened. I remember I left school around 3 o'clock in the afternoon and it was already super dark, like night. But then everything starts getting lighter and lighter and lighter, and around May it was already day during the night. And you already have this like amazing sunsets and sunrises full of like colors, like orangey and pink colors. When I was in exchange, of course, I made a lot of friends. I had a lot of work to do at school also, but not that much because you don't have as many courses or classes as I had in Portugal. So I actually had a lot of time to get to know Norway. I went to Rindal, Røros, I went to Oslo, to Preikestolen, and I also went in like a car trip with some friends. Traveling in Norway, I think it was one of the best experiences I had in my entire life. The landscape is incredible. The nature, the wildlife, everything changes. Nothing is boring when you are driving. You have to save some money to go travel. I also made some hikings. We had this Norwegian guy that was like leading us because none of us was really like Scandinavian and everything was full of snow. So this Norwegian guy was like the leader. It was so, so cold. I stopped feeling my feet. I stopped feeling my hands. I remember at some point, all of my hair was frozen, like on the tips. The way we were walking, it was super slippery. And everyone was afraid of falling down the mountain. It was my first time walking on a frozen lake. And in the middle of the lake, we were walking and we heard this huge crack. The ice underneath us was moving a little bit, like it cracked. But we just freaked out and started running. They told us it was not actually dangerous. It's even like normal that the ice cracks and stuff. After that, I walked several times in frozen lakes, as you do in Norway. And it was a little bit better. In the end, we had to say goodbye to everyone. It was really, really sad. But yeah, I think that's everything. If you think I am missing something, just tell me in the comments below, because maybe I'll do a second video about it or I can answer your questions. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video and I truly, truly hope this video can be helpful to you. If you are going to Trondheim, to NTNU in exchange, just tell me in the comments. Ask me everything you would like to know, and I'm sure you will have a blast. There is always times you feel down, you feel alone, far away from your family and your friends, and I know this can be really, really hard. You just have to remember that everyone that is there is in the same situation as you are. So just stick together, enjoy the time you have there, because in a blink of an eye, everything ends really quickly. So enjoy the time you have there. I hope you guys have a wonderful weekend and I'll see you next week with another video. Bye!